Logistic regression is one of the most basic forms of regression modeling. It's part of a family of generalized linear models, or GLM for short, which basically means that the formula is very similar to that of a linear regression. However, since the target variable is in categories instead of a continuous numeric variable, the target variable has to be modified to fit this GLM formula. Let's go back and revisit that formula from lesson one for a moment. Patrick presented the linear regression formula that you see on the screen here. As a reminder, in this equation, y is the target variable, beta naught is the intercept or the baseline value, and b1 or beta 1, beta 2, beta 3, all the way to beta n represents the coefficients for the different variables, x1, x2, x3, all the way to xn as well. So let's compare this formula to one of the logistic regression formulas, and yep, there are actually more than one of them. Let's first focus on the right-hand side of the equation. The right-hand side of the equation is actually identical to that of a linear regression, where again, beta naught represents the intercept or the baseline value, beta 1, beta 2, beta 3, all the way up to beta n again, represents the coefficients of the variables x1, x2, x3, again, all the way to xn. Now, what is going on the left-hand side of the equation? Well, don't be scared. This is clearly where the logistic regression separates from that of a linear regression. But actually, it is conceptually very similar. What we are trying to do is find the probability of P, which represents an outcome. Like in our example, P represents the probability of yes, they will redeem. The natural log is also in this equation to deal with the binary nature of this problem.